With years of groundbreaking work that aids in the recovery of species such as whooping cranes, Patuxent Research Refuge celebrated their 75th anniversary in October of 2011. The nation's only national wildlife refuge established to support wildlife research, the celebration brought together past scientists and employees with current staff.
This event today and the next couple of days, where we're celebrating the 75th anniversary of Patuxent Research Refuge and Patuxent Wildlife Research Center, is really bringing together a lot of the alumni, people from years ago that used to work here and work here for decades.
Well, it's great because I'm seeing people that I knew socially, besides being colleagues here, like Chan Robbins. I mean, I used to go to the Patuxent Bird Club, which probably still exists.
I'm also meeting a lot of new people that have either retired or maybe I haven't met yet that have also been working here for a really long time. And it's great to see how much dedication there is to the research. People like Chan Robbins, who've been working here for over 60 years.
The 75th anniversary is just amazing to have so many of the former employees come back and share their experiences with us.
It's just sort of nostalgic. It's nice to be back with people I worked with before or knew before, and exchange memories and talk about what they're doing now. And it's wonderful to see that they have gone on and done other things and are still excited about their work in biology. Yeah.
The two-day celebration included a science symposium that highlighted work conducted at Patuxent, including research that led to the banning of the pesticide DDT.
The general research of, you know, environmental contaminants and toxicology has led to a, you know, breadth of information that has benefited us in the Fish and Wildlife Service in so many ways, of understanding the relationship between toxins in the environment and the environment to the species that we're very concerned about and have been for years.
Patuxent's very unique, and when I was here in the 1980s, I don't think I had anywhere near the appreciation of the scope and the breadth and the dedication of the researchers that have really made a huge impact in terms of conservation on a global scale.
The celebration concluded with Patuxent's annual Wildlife Festival. The public enjoyed live animals, research displays, tram tours and behind-the-scenes tours of the refuge and research center, and various children's activities. At the festival, Representative John Sarbanes addressed why Patuxent is a great place to connect youth with the outdoors.
And in order to do it, we need to have
a lot of good things happening here, and the thing is, you never know what's going to happen next, and it's constantly changing and evolving.
On a daily basis, though, it's just the opportunities here, the challenges, the resource challenges, the public use challenges, the relationship with the research center. It's just a very satisfying place to work.
I'm retired now and enjoying doing some other things, but I won't forget my Patuxent days.
It's my home. It has been all these many, many years.
Patuxent Research Refuge and Research Center is an important link in the National Wildlife Refuge System and will continue to protect the nation's wildlife through its cutting-edge conservation science.